Greetings, Foodlings. Welcome back to Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Now, I am actually re-recording this intro because I was not satisfied with the way that it turned out initially. This video is probably going to be quite short. I haven't gotten around to editing it yet because it hardly has any content. The MetaGrid that we were talking about in the last video was essentially a very, very short time attack. it's hardly worth capturing on its own, and it barely lasted a minute. So yeah, and the main focus of this video is probably us trying to access yet another grid node, and that's pretty much the only section in this video that I ended up liking quite a lot, the grid node hacking segment. At any rate, I actually went ahead and read some of the lore of Mirror's Edge Catalyst. The original website had it. I mean, it's sort of sad. The lore is so finely made, finely crafted, that they did not include it in the game is a very sad thing indeed. Because I was hoping that they would somehow, you know, get the message across, but it's not mentioned anywhere in the comics or in the game. You had to essentially go to mirrorsedge.com back in the day when this game actually released to read the lore. And a person has archived it on Steam. You can find the link to the archived article on Steam, essentially, on either the description of my first video or in the description of the entire playlist itself. Now, with that out of the way, I just want to expand on the lore a little bit and just say that this entire region, like Cascadia, that is essentially a communist dystopia. The entire lore is very political in nature, and there's like quite a lot of ideology and commentary going on behind the scenes, which is, I suppose, pretty apparent in the story as well, thus far at least, especially with Nomad's missions and the story of Faith's, you know, parents, which they didn't really touch much upon in the first game. So I suppose when you think about things that way, this reboot might be a good restart if they do capitalize upon the opportunity granted to them by the lore department, at least by the, you know, writing department. Anyway, so essentially there was this one region somewhere in the fictional world of Mirror's Edge called OMNISTAT, and I don't exactly know whether that country was called OMNISTAT or not, but it was essentially a region that was governed by a military. It was a communist dictatorship, which came to be known as OMNISTAT. Now, by and by, because of, you know, famine and lots of other natural disasters that are common when, you know, civilization progresses to an extent where they no longer care about the resources that they're pillaging. So, yeah, essentially OMNISTAT reached a certain place like that. And what ended up happening was Kreuger sick, along with 11 or 12 others, I don't exactly recall how many right now, but 11 or 12 other companies, they had like this sort of uprising and overthrew the government, essentially. This forced OMNISTAT to, well, essentially withdraw and hand over control to these corporations. And OMNISTAT essentially broke into three parts. You already heard about OMNISTAT being mentioned in the previous video. Plus mentioned OMNISTAT saying that the drive that she was decrypting essentially had OMNISTAT military grade and encryption. That portion of the world that is called OMNISTAT today still has essentially the same status quotient. It has not changed at all, but OMNISTAT is broken into three parts. One of them is essentially Cascadia, the place where Faith and the rest of the runners live. These are essentially a privatized communist society, if that is even possible, but yeah, it's communist in nature. You can tell by the citizenship program and everything, and it's essentially a privatized communist society, which is headed by a government known as the conglomerate, because the 12 corporations, or 13 perhaps corporations that I talked about before, they all banded together to form what is now known as the conglomerate. And there apparently was a government to govern it, and slowly it declined over time. People started rioting. And that is where the November riots come in place, when they had enrolled the citizenship program. And the government lost. The government lost the civil war. And As a result, Cascadia is now completely privatized. Glass is just one of those cities in Cascadia, and it is supposed to be the most beautiful city. The third country that got carved out of the original OMNISTAT would be Sebaeus, if I'm not butchering the name or the pronunciation. It's apparently Sebaeus, and not much is known about it, to be honest, except for the fact that it's a theocracy. Now, if the trend is to be followed, it's probably a theocratic communism, communist society, but yeah, I mean, according to the lore, no matter who's sent there to investigate and or infiltrate the society, they all just end up being converted to their religion. So not much is known about it. And all of these little details just make me excited about the potential and possibilities that this game has to offer. Like, if they choose to capitalize on the lore, either in this game or some other like series of games in the future, it could actually be really, really well. At any rate, there's also like a bunch of castes, because of course it's a communist society, so there have to be castes among the workers in, you know, Cascadia. And well, there are the executives, which are a step below the owners, but they're still employees. And yeah, essentially they have like the highest level of privilege. You can consider them ministers in a monarchy, like, you know, the prime minister in England. So they're essentially that, except they don't have as much political influence. And then there are the high caste, higher tier workers, mid caste, mid tier workers, and then there's the low caste, or the low tier workers. And every single strata of this entire stratified society essentially has different levels of rights and access, which is something that is insane. But I suppose that is why this is a communist dystopia that they've shown in Mirror's Edge, and the lore is just so finely crafted. There are also like these other groups that are outcasts, essentially, that have no, you know, place in society, or they've been like exiled from society. So yeah, I mean, if you don't work properly, you can essentially get knocked down a tier. If you work well, you can get bumped up a tier. And yeah, there's like a lot of politics behind the scenes, a lot of corruption, which actually we don't really get to see a lot while playing this game. We'll obviously get to learn more about it. We do get to learn more about it in Mirror's Exodium through a few, you know, scenes that are just there on the side meant as film material, but they do shed some insight into how things work in Cascadia, and especially in Glass City. But apart from that, there are also these people called off-grids that are neither a part of the society and refuse to be part of it in exchange for freedom, of course. So they're essentially criminals. And Faith here and the rest of the runners are essentially off-grids. They live off the grid. They have no desire to be a part of the society, but they, in a very political sense, do leech off it, because they are utilizing the resources made by the same communist government that they choose not to be a part of, the same society that they do not choose to be a part of, which sort of makes sense as to why all the Kreuger Sect guards in this game call us leeches. And in this game, especially from what I've noticed, there are no cops. The original Mirror's Edge had a police department. This one has none, and it just ties into the narrative just perfectly. At any rate, I have talked about the lore, well, rather touched upon it. There's a lot more, and I really do urge you guys to go ahead and read it. But I have talked about the lore at length. For an introduction to a video, I mean. But at any rate, yeah. Let us go ahead and address the video now. So, let us begin.
Employees of Glass, our city has been attacked. You have been attacked. The group called Black November has claimed responsibility for the bombing of the Bobble Mall, and I wanted to personally guarantee you that Kreuger Sect will not rest until the perpetrators are found and dealt with. I will not stand idly by while someone is threatening me or those under my care, and actions are already being taken to ensure that this vile deed is not repeated. Together, we have created a world where we celebrate individual freedom and enterprise.
A world where everyone who contributes is rewarded with safety and prosperity. Will you let these leeches tear that to pieces? I don't think so. Will you let them destroy all that we have built? I don't think so. If you have any information regarding this terrible calamity, you must report it to KreugerSec. Failure to do so is a breach of policy and grounds for contract termination. I am Gabriel Kreuger. Thank you.
They want us to rid ourselves.
I'm bored. I fiddled around Sky City enclosed environmental protocols for a while, but they shut down the whole system after the blizzard. Hey, I have an idea. You can help me access the MetaGrid.
What?
The MetaGrid. It's part of the grid, but only accessible by corporate families.
Oh, no.
It consists of information and communication too sensitive to risk propagation on the regular grid.
How do we access it?
I've mapped out geolocational weaknesses in the MetaGrid encryption. If you could tap into those nexus points, I can assemble them to get full access.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Just go to the locations I've marked for you, and I'll handle the rest. Once you reach the first point, their safety protocols will race to shut you out. You need to reach all the points before that happens.
Okay, I got it. I think.
Right, just give me a moment there because I'm getting a few lag spikes in this game, so let me try and address that. Right, so I guess this should make things a little better. This game has a tendency to lag, especially during cutscenes, and it has... Sorry about that. Yeah, it has been becoming sort of a pain for me. Especially since I did not mean to do that, but I have a feeling that I'm going to be sucking at today's, at today's attempts at parkour. Almost fell, I feel like. What am I even standing on right now? Yeah, the game's still lagging every now and then. Excuse me? What just happened there? Excuse me, the game is lagging a lot. I've heard that this game has issues with lag, and one of the ways to solve it is to set the priority mode higher. Now, I tried doing that, but I don't know. The game still does seem to be lagging and not responding to inputs now at this point in time. There's a dash back there, but I'm not certain that I want to go there yet. Okay, we landed in some water. At least it wasn't hot water. Let us continue. If it keeps lagging, I'll go ahead and... Okay.
The firewalls will try to shut you out. And that's bad. You'll just have to be faster than they are.
Gotcha. Okay, I will actually need to... I could have gone ahead and dealt with that thing, but I actually need to go ahead and... Plastic intents to tap into the MetaGrid, a closed-off network reserved for the conglomerate elite. There are certain weakened geolocational data points that she can use to hack into the network, similar to grid leaks, but she will need your help. You need to access every data point within a given area. Plastic will tap into them through you, but once she starts the race, the race is on to finish before the firewall shuts everything down. If that happens, you'll need to start over. I actually do not know if I can accomplish this right now, but let's try. Is that the way? Oh, okay, okay. It's like a time attack sort of thing. What the fuck?
The safety protocol just activated.
That's not a good. Alright, I hope everything's stable right now. I mean, it is lagging a bit.
The safety protocol just activated.
On it.
Only a few left to go.
Should have jumped off the other thing there. Alright, let's go. We still have that thing there. Oh, okay. That's it.
That's it. Did it. Plenty of juicy stuff here. I'll make
make sure you get a share of the script for this phase.
Alright, so we did get like more upgrade points to use, so that's, I suppose, a good thing. Enforcer. More damage to enforcers, I suppose. That is the only unlockable that we have right now, so might as well go for it. And then there's this shock detector intel on them. And there's like an intel on the sentinel. I see, that's pretty much what we faced back then. So where are we headed again? Does she have any more work for us? Benefactor? That's basically talking to Noah Clear. Where was the Gridnode thing? Hackable billboard? Not exactly interested per se. Bugging Vifo. Diversion opportunity. That's new. We essentially passed by a security hub there. There's like a Gridnode that we can hack into. That is something that I am definitely interested in. So slowly over time, the entirety of this map is becoming more and more available to us. So this is the other thing that we want to do today. Take care of this Gridnode. Not exactly interested in doing that. Bugging Vifo though. Bugging Vifo. Let us go ahead and try to see whatever that is. Actually, let me just stay down there. Yeah. Gives me an opportunity to collect that. And this is pretty much the path I took while running back to... Oh hey, control chip. What's her name? That woman's residence. Excuse me. The game is slowly stabilizing. I see. Holy shit, that was... iffy. What is this? Is this...
Hey, maybe you can help me
How do you
out,
know
eh?
Me by name? Is this the way we have to go? Might be, actually.
You used to do diversions all the time back in the day, right? Well, nothing's changed. Keep Kreuger Sec busy while I plant this bug inside WFYO.
I see. So where are we headed? Down there. Okay, gotcha. Alright, here we go. We essentially need to provide a diversion to some people. So it's more for a cheese mission of sorts. Whoops, not what I wanted to do. This is essentially a... time attack. Nothing more, nothing less. It's just disguised as something else. Why did you decide to? Come on, shift. Subject is resisting, apparently. We can get to this one just fine. Where did all the bad guys go? Interesting question, if you ask me. But we are sort of running a little late for this one. And we're done. So we essentially have to go up there.
Damn.
Yeah, let's abort this.
I'm out.
Because, well, it's honestly pretty useless. What the fuck, you bitch. Right, so I guess, yeah, they're off our team now. So let us go ahead and, of course, we can go ahead and do that, shall we? Let's go. We can essentially just counter these guys left and right without any issues whatsoever. These guys aren't shit. You can easily take care of them. The real issue now is going to be getting back. Visual acquisition for subject, they said. We're apparently headed this way. Our job is to avoid these guys and just keep running as much as possible. That is apparently not where we're headed. Or maybe we are, who knows. I can't seem to make heads or tails of this area. Could be where we're going, who knows. I've got no idea where I am anymore. All I know is that we can't stay in here. We have to figure out a way out. That is definitely not the way we wanted to go. So I guess we are going down there then. Back that way? Where am I headed? Definitely not that way, because that's where it came from. Woo, shit. Attempt number two. This time, we should have like a head start on the VTOL. So that is good, I suppose. Subject won't submit, conversion pacifier. Is what they said. Get out of sight. Essentially, we need to evade this threat right here. That's the veto. Could have taken that, but we decided not to. Looks like they're headed downstairs. Is that it? Where am I headed now? Like, it's sort of strange that we're coming this way. Look at all of these things looking at us. Interesting, but where is this place? I see something up there. Okay, what is this again? Why am I headed there again? Like, it's telling me to go there, but I don't know why. What's strange is it did not actually tell me to go that way back when I was... I think this game is sort of bugging out at this point. Yeah, I have no idea why it asked me to come here. At any rate, let us go ahead and hack this Gridnode. We have got like basic kits there, but I hardly want to have anything to do with them. Let us go ahead and hack the Gridnode then. And how do we get there is the question. Oh, wait. A control ship. Come on, steal it. What the fuck were you waiting for back then? Actually, let me collect that as well, while I still can. It's strange, she didn't turn all the way. That way? Alright. The satellite destruction missions are pretty straightforward, so... Yeah, we don't exactly want to go for any of these dashes right now. Excuse me? Get up there. Come on. I don't know why this game is lagging so hard, even despite the fact that I've set the priority mode higher. Let me just go ahead and set it again. Alright, let's try. Well, it's certainly lagging less, but I don't really know how long that's gonna last. Did we just do like a backwards roll? That is impressive. That is impressive indeed. Since I don't know any of the way here, like how to proceed here. Almost fell. Okay, we jump over that, and then we jump onto that. Then we apparently slide onto that. It's difficult to tell what's what in this game. Wait, what's that? Oh, just some humans. Nothing much. I feel like we're close to the place that we need to, you know, take to get back now. It's strange the way she turned. Can be like, thank you. No need to climb down all sophisticated like. It's strange, we are sort of taking like a different path back. I would have thought we would take like a different path, but apparently not, we're taking a different path back.
With rumors about the explosion, some are blaming the runners.
Indeed.
But why would you bomb the bubble?
Exactly, Plastic. You get it.
Of course I get it.
Here we are. Mag rope. A little late of a deployment though. Destruct. It's almost like a super bar.
Hey you! Over here.
Really? She loves me not. Fragile delivery. You're running yourself, why do you need me to deliver something for you? Did you get like too much scrip from some of your jobs, or do you like not run if it's not for money or something? What's going on here? Low cost and mid cost. This place is apparently downtown. So this world is divided into multiple castes. Being a socialism. Obviously.
Help me out, Faith.
Under surveillance. Diversion. Nah, I'm cool. Oh, hey, security chip. I just wish that the game wouldn't lag as much. But I suppose there's nothing that can be done about that. Excuse me. Come on, Faith, you can do it. Climb up there. Master the grid. I love parkour in this game, like just the entire notion of free running. I just wish it wouldn't like lag so hard, you know, all the time. Are you? Why are you here right now? Interesting. Did not expect to see you there, of all places. Excuse me? It's strange, she can't exactly... Right. Gridnode downtown. Subvert the Gridnode CCU and connect it to your beatlink in order to expand your coverage in the city. Hacking a Gridnode opens up fast travel options in the affected area. Cool. Here we are. Time to hack into this Gridnode in downtown. Am I missing something? What's going on? I doubt I can go there, but it's like every single time that I reach down there, it's sort of just... I fall to my death, essentially, is what happens. Let's try jumping. Okay, so we were supposed to go for this pipe, apparently. But Faith would not grab onto it on her own. I don't really know what happened. Yeah, so I don't know how long I've been doing that, but I had apparently been commentating with the recording button off for some time back there. So I don't know how much of my commentary you guys actually caught or didn't catch for that matter. The path forward seems simple enough. I mean, there are two alternatives that we can try. One of them is right there, although I don't know how I'll scale up that side. There's also this yellow line there, but on the other hand, if I'm to go that away, I don't know what's awaiting me that away, to be honest. But let us try this way first. Okay, so we definitely need to be wall running for this to work. There's something else here, but the question is, why did I even come here? Okay, not really a lot here. Like, there's not much here. Just this one area right here, and what else? Just that, pretty much. Excuse me. I don't think I can go back now that I'm here. I think the only way forward is to, yeah, pretty much just follow this route again. I guess it's like a fail-safe for when you fail to get to the top and like you drop down. I guess what that means is that we're going this way. Come on. Huh. And there seems to be that thing over there, but there's also that. Whoa, talk about input lag. Not appreciated in a game that's all about platforming. Definitely not appreciated. That side. I don't think this side leads anywhere, but let's just check nonetheless. I see this golden line right here. I can probably make it to that platform over there. Trying to jump onto this cube here will only lead to troubles, but let's try. Oh, it's a pipe! It's a pipe! Okay, got it. It's a pipe. Huh. I was getting my panties up a bunch over nothing, essentially. So that is where we need to go, apparently, from the looks of it. But apparently we had to do it on the pipe. Because now that I've come here without it, we're sort of stranded at this point. Alright, here we are. Just hoping that it did not trigger anything. I guess back onto the pipe we go then. Pretty sure we can't run up to that one, so we just essentially need to grab this one and keep moving. Good to see that we aren't exactly activating anything. And good to see the fact that we did not break our bones with that fall. You're making a whole bunch of noise, Faith. I hope you know that. Okay, so we have to get there, but what good does getting there do us? Not much from the looks of it, because we just came around the same way. We could actually, like, we probably could have done that. Let's just crouch walk right here. Again, I've got no idea what good this does us, but yeah. Let me try something right here. Let's try. Doesn't hurt to try, I suppose. Did I trip this thing? Apparently not, though. Alright, so I guess we head back this way then. And somehow we are to get up there. Right. That's what that does for us. What just happened there? This game is bugging out hard right now. And I honestly don't know what's going on. So, yeah, from the looks of it, we can't exactly grab it from right here. This pipe, I mean. Maybe wall run and jump off it? Right then. For now, let's face this way. We'll begin our jumping off once we get there. Good job, Faith. Good job. Good on you. Now then, now we're like a step above where we're supposed to be. But I suppose we can latch onto this pipe now that we're here. Because that is apparently where we have to go. But the question is, once we get there, what are we going to do? Like, we could probably jump onto that platform from there. But then there's that thing there, it's sort of blocking our way. We can't exactly cross over using this pipe. We have to find some other means around, like some other means through. Well, looks like we're clear of that. I mean, that thing, I don't know, I can't tell whether that's on top of the pipe or below it, to be honest. And we've got singing photons all over the place. So that's something. Alright, let's try grabbing onto this pipe, because I, personally, I can't see any other way forward, or can I? Let's try coming over this way, and what else do we have? Anything? Like, there's like that thing over there, but how do we access it though, is the question. Like, fine, we can make it, if even if we do make it over onto that side, there's nothing on the other side to help us access it. I guess we have to use some other pipe or that walkway over there to come back this towards this end to get there. Alright, pipe it is. Grid nodes are always nice if they're like a platform puzzle. Ooh, I forgot that she can do this. I really did. Can we? Like, can we make it to that? I'm not certain we can, but it doesn't hurt to try, I suppose. Whew. Never in a million years did I think that that would be possible, but... Well, Mirror's Edge Catalyst surprises me. Look at you, Faith. You're like... you're like a little monkey. Climbing up everywhere, causing a racket. That seems to be where we need to go, but... I can see a walkway over there. We could probably jump down from there, because this side seems a little risky for the time being. And as we have now found out, we cannot exactly run on glass, so... Okay. But there's also this, like, laser in between to make things difficult for us. We can actually do that. That is insane. So, once we're here, let us go ahead and drop down. She's an acrobat. She's a natural born acrobat is what she is. Faith, I mean. Is this it? Okay, there are two CCUs. We now need to reach the second one, and from the looks of it, the lasers in this area at least have been disabled, so... Holy lag. Holy lag indeed. I guess that's what we're aiming for then. Let us climb up and latch onto that one, and looks like that's where we go. That way. Should be safe here? Right. And probably did not need to do it in such a hurry, but here we are. Now, next step, finding a way there. I mean, I can already see a way, but it's a little too far for us to make this jump right now. So, yeah. I see a way there. I guess we're taking the long way around. I mean, it's sort of self-explanatory. Explanatory. Anyhow. Interesting. I guess there are like multiple CCUs that we need to connect to. And we could probably take a shortcut to get there. We probably don't need to take this entire way around, but let's see. Let's try. Let's try anyway. We safely made it across. Oh. Right. There's like a whole bunch of singing photons here. Interesting. Yeah, no way we're getting up there without going all the way around. And we could try right here. Like, try jumping there by landing on this platform, but I'm pretty sure we'll be triggering an alarm when we do that, so let us just head back like good little boys, or ghouls in this case, and yeah. Let us find a more sane path to where we want to go. Interesting. I wonder what's up there. A tertiary grid node, perhaps? I mean, that would make sense. Here we are. The objective has now changed and it is telling us to go there. So the game is essentially giving us hints at this point. I actually missed one of those runner bags when I was playing the level that introduced us to these grid nodes. So I guess we are climbing, latching onto that one up there. Which makes the most sense, to be honest. No use going there, I feel like. Excuse me, can we like stop lagging for a second or two, please? Thank you. This should keep us from... that's a way that we have to go, so... Excuse me? What's happened there? So we safely made it across. Now we need to get there. And we can just slide under it and take that route, or... Yeah, it's a little too far right now. Better to not risk it. Can we like move? Thank you. Is there... Yeah. There is space to drop down there. Alright. Here we are. It feels like she sort of holds her breath while running along the walls. Based on... how the screen turns like black whenever she does that. There's like a CCU here. The secondary CCU that we need to trigger, and it should be behind this door right here. Yeah, right here. Now, the only thing that remains is to exit this place, the grid node. Okay, now this is actually telling us to go this way, so you know what, we'll follow it. Oh, right. It was so dark I couldn't tell that there was something there. And here we are. Gridnode downtown completed. 500 XP. Hmm. Yeah, so apparently, I suppose what the Gridnodes do is they provide a surveillance mechanism for the for essentially part of the city. So if you shut them down, they should help you remain anonymous, essentially. So with that being done, we should be able to travel to the safe house now. Primary drive. Hmm. That's like the place where we need to go. Let's try fast traveling though, no? We can't do that, amazing. And we're back. So yeah, that was that for today's video. It was sort of different, I mean more of a puzzle-oriented video, but I am slowly just going around and getting rid of all the side quests that I find interesting and checking new stuff out because, well, this game has potential. At least it's fun to do all of that. I apparently missed a security hub there. Next time then. Next time. There's like a lot of space to cover in the city. Not that I do intend on fast traveling, that doesn't really work out in my favor, but yeah, there is a lot of space. Like, solving the grid node puzzles is quite interesting. It's like pretty much the entire reason why, like a huge part of the reason why I like Mirror's Edge. Like, I like puzzle platformers. Do I really need to talk to Noah before I can access the rest of the place then? Apparently so, because I can't do it. Like, I can't access the rest of the place without talking to Noah first. Which is sort of strange, actually. At any rate, I guess this is the entrance to the lair. Yellow everywhere. So as to not bring attention to runners. Or is it the case that this game does not have that red theory about runners? I mean, just look at it. Everything is blue right here. Everything. With splashes of yellow here and there. At any rate, next time we come back, we will be covering Benefactor, and I will try to do something about the lag that the system is going through. I tried a fix that I saw online by raising the process priority, but that is apparently not really working out. So yeah, I'll have to try something else, to be honest. At any rate, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time I come back, we'll pick off from right here. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow old things.